Hello, and today we're going to look at rounding. So I have set this up in a manner in which there are three rules, and we'll look at the first one I've come up with. So rule number one, you can see it here. If the remainder beyond the last digit to be reported or rounded is less than 5, drop the last digit. So if we're looking at, and we'll say no to that, if we are looking at rounding to the tenths place, then we look to the next number. In this case, it's a 4. It is less than 5. Therefore, we would have our number rounded looking like this. Okay? If we had 1, 5, 4, 2, 1, and again we were rounding to that tenths place, same thing. Tell my guys, look, we're looking beyond to the next place. In this case it's 2, that's less than 5. Here it is, here, less than 5. So we would simply leave our number that we're rounding, we leave it as is. So this would be 15.4. So simply put, if it's 1, 2, 3, or 4, you would leave it. You would not bump. Okay? Just as we did, just as in these cases here. Okay? So we left them. So rule number 2 looks like this. If the remainder is greater than 5, increase the final digit by 1. So we would say we bump that one up. So in this case, we're going to do the same. So we have a look here, 5.7, so we're rounding to 1 decimal place or the tenths place. And if we look, we see, that looks like I'm pointing at the 8, but it's the 9. And we'd say that is greater than 5. So we would bump 5.798 to 5. Okay, what's going on here? This doesn't want to write. Sorry about that. Must have bumped something. 5.8. There we go. Okay, so let's look at one more quick one. 9.68. And we're doing the same. We're rounding to the tenths place, 1 decimal place. We would look, and the 8 is greater than 5, so we would say 9.7. So just like in the previous example, we said 1, 2, 3, and 4, you would leave or not bump it. 6, 7, 8, 9, you would bump or increase by 1. Okay, let's look at what I've come up with for rule 3. Now, this doesn't always happen. This is a rule. You'll see this in some instances. I find in a lot of the lower elementary grades, this doesn't happen. Probably too much for the smaller, younger students to remember. But when you get up into the high school and university, when you get into high school and university problems, I suggest that this is probably your best with regards to rounding bias. Okay. Okay. So here's what it is. I'll read this to you quickly. If the remainder is exactly 5, then round the last digit to the closest even number. Thus, the number 3.55, rounded to 1 digit, so we're still going to the tenths place, would be 3.6, rounding up. And the number 6.45, again rounding to the tenths place, would round to 6.4. Well, I kind of look at that. That's the rule. And here's what I, just a little hint for my students. Again, we're just keeping this consistent. We're always going to round. We're just rounding these ones to the tenths place, but of course we can round these anywhere. Ones, tenths, hundreds, what have you. In this case, the number that we're looking at is a 5. So rather than bumping all the time, bumping that up to a 6, right? Or if you had something like, you know, this one here, bumping it all the time, right? Of course there, you know. Rounding bias. Half the time you bump the number and half the time you don't. So simply put, here's what I kind of tell my students, if the number is odd that you're rounding, in this case the 5 is odd, and of course it's followed by a 5, which of course is the magic number here, okay? Of course, if this was 3.56, then that wouldn't be an issue, right? Rounding to the tenths, you would have 3.6, okay? So that's not what I'm saying. If the number that you're looking at to round is a 5, and your number is odd, this just so happens to be a 5. Maybe to make this a little clearer, we could do something like this. I know my example up here is 3.55, but what if I said this, 3.35? Some of you might be a little confused because these are both 5. So again, we have an odd number. It's a 5. Then what I tell my students, if the number that you're rounding to is odd and it's followed by a 5, then you bump. So this would be 3.4. And over here, this one would be 3.6. This is odd. It's followed by a 5. Bump it. Now, rounding bias, let's flip this around. The example in our question here is 6.450. We're again rounding to the tenths just to keep this consistent. And again, here's our 5. So we look at the 5, same as we did before, to see what we're going to do with this place, and it's even, so we would leave it as is. So in this example here, in this rule, what you end up with is 50% of the time when you're looking at a 5, 50% of the time you are leaving your value, and 50% of the time you bump it, and that should prevent rounding bias. Okay, I know that in the elementary grades, when they're looking at rounding, for the most part, if it's 5, you know, we've always been taught if it's 5 or greater, we bump it. But if you're always bumping that 5, then at some point your data is going to be skewed. So anyway, that's my take on this, and I hope this has helped. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, and I will get back to you. Thanks, and have a great day.